Here it is, small enough, easy to handle. It only weighs about 9 pounds when this tank on top is filled with gasoline. That's what fuels this, and this is igniting a firestorm of controversy. He's an educated automotive engineer working a day job and an entrepreneur at night, now getting worldwide attention. He's fanning the flames himself with this slick video he produced about his design from car parts.
Is it a tool or is it a weapon?
It's always been designed as a tool, as an entertainment device, really. I just wanted it. Throw fire, looks cool, it's fun display.
On his website, he lists these uses: clearing snow and ice, eliminating weeds, controlled burns, bonfires. By design, his website does not say where he's located. He doesn't want to get attacked. This is it, off to one side, inside a machine shop in Warren. His friend here does the welding. No walk-in cash and carry here. The only place to buy his website, $900. $1,000 for a color brushed finish, and get this, no questions asked.
All we know is, you know, whatever's available on the credit card and billing address. We're not doing any sort of background checks or anything like that.
He got started this year with an online crowd campaign that raised capital, and he paid those investors with his product. That was some 200 flamethrowers. He assembles most of them himself, one at a time, trying to keep up with demand.
We have a pretty big backlog to work through, hoping to ship everything out by the end of August.
Making such a potentially dangerous product, he ships them out with a ton of disclaimers, and he believes no liability.
Do you lay awake at night worrying about that, the ramifications down the road?
No, it's on them. If they use this in an improper manner, I mean, that's the individual's prerogative.
His website shows 48 states where this is legal to own, carry, and use his flamethrower. Yep, including Michigan, Maryland, and California have restrictions. Decades ago, the Geneva Convention banned flamethrowers as weapons in war. Take a look at why.
I can feel the heat. Wow. Has anyone called the fire department while you've done this out here?
No, we actually thought they would. We heard some sirens once and ran inside, but...
The flame shoots 25 feet long. The gas tank runs out after 35 seconds. The legal trouble may be close.
To what extent have you done your legal homework to make sure police are not going to come swarming in to shut
right.
you down?
Now, we've done a little research on the legality, and as far as we know, it's legal everywhere. It's not classified. There's no laws against ownership or usage of it.
Now, what do you think about this? We took this to the streets in Warren and Detroit. It's made not far from Detroit. We're going to have people's reaction to this coming up tonight at 6 o'clock. I also called Warren and Detroit for official comment. They must be befuddled because I'm still not getting a call back. Ladies?
All right, Jim. Boy, gosh, hopefully you've cooled off by now after working with that thing. Hey, before you go, is there anything being done right now to make those flamethrowers illegal or to even stop production?
I've talked to some police and fire guys behind the scenes, not the official spokespeople. They're very, very concerned about this. They say this cannot be out on the streets, but they also say to get some sort of city ordinance or a state law change, that's going to take a long time, but we'll be watching.
We know you will. All right, Jim. Thank you so much.